In this session, we show you how to use your project library. Open a project and click on Library in the left-hand panel. Your library contains all media assets added to reviews of that project, as well as those that have been uploaded from your computer but are not yet attached to a review. You can think of media assets as the containers for your successive versions or iterations. Your asset could be a media file of a 3D model, a storyboard, a shot in your film or commercial, print advertisement, or any other creative project you are iterating on towards approval. Let's begin by uploading a new version. Click here to browse your files. If you select a file with the same name as an existing version, it will ask you if you want to version up the existing asset or make a new one. We are going to make a new asset and rename it. You can see each media asset shows you the number of reviews it is attached to, the storage used by that asset, which is the total sum of the versions it contains, as well as the asset type. You can drag and drop a media asset containing one version onto another, which will combine the versions into a single asset. The asset being dragged will take on the name of the asset it is being dropped onto, and the versions within will be sequentially numbered in order of the existing versions. Each asset has a checkbox in the top left corner. If you select one or many assets, you are given a menu pop-up which allows you to either permanently delete the selected or share to a new review or add to an existing one. The three-dot menu at the top right of an asset also gives you the option to delete and share, as well as unversion the asset and upload a new version. Selecting Unversion will separate the latest version from the asset's version stack, making it its own unique asset. The remaining versions will stay a part of the original asset. Repeat this process to separate any or all versions as needed. Upload New Version lets you add one or many versions to that asset. Any file you select will automatically be given the same naming convention as the asset it's being added to, and versioned up sequentially in the file order selected. You can then choose to update any review containing that asset with a new version or versions, if you added more than one, by selecting the review and saving. If you don't select the review and save, the versions will not be added. If you want to organize your library other than the single alphabetical layer of assets, you can create folders to group relative assets together. You can drag and drop individual assets into your folder or multi-select using the checkbox and drag them as one. Click on your folder to see the contents within. You can even make folders within folders if you need additional layers of organization. Once your assets are in a folder, the three-dot menu will allow you to move that asset up one folder level as needed by selecting Move to Parent. If we go back to the main library level, we can see our version Coast 01 has found its new home there. Going back into our Coast folder, you'll see if you have layers of folders, the Folders three-dot menu will also allow you to move the entire folder group of assets up one level. Or you can choose to permanently delete any folder, its trickle-down folders and assets, and all feedback by selecting Delete. Back in the main library, let's view one of our assets by clicking Open. This will take you to a simplified player where you can compare versions if you have more than one, as well as make internal annotations and notes. It's important to highlight that any feedback you add within the library player will be internal feedback only viewable in the library player, and it won't be accessible when you play the same asset version in a review. This allows you to hide any internal notes that you don't want a client seeing in a shared review. In the Feedback tab of the right-hand panel, feedback added to that version in a review will be headlined with the review name and version name. You'll see the familiar activity and details tabs beside feedback, giving you additional information about your queued up version. You can rename the asset at the top and also see what reviews that asset is a part of. The toolbar contains your playback options, resolution, and time format, a laser tool to temporarily highlight an area on screen, clear annotations to clear any drawings you've made on that frame, your ever-handy keyboard shortcuts for those that love a good hotkey, zoom, pan, full screen viewing mode, and a very useful download button. This allows internal review site users to download the selected version in their preferred resolution to their computer or network as desired. And there you have the library, my friends. We hope you enjoyed this session, and we'll see you in the next one.